Hello everyone, welcome back to the FEC, and as seen in the title, there's going to be quite a few specialties, and even a nice little friend hangout. First up, we have a train with an SD40-2 Duo, 713 and number 714, both trailing on train 206. This was filmed a day before my friend actually came over for the special trains you'll be seeing here in a moment. Just like that, 206 is gone, and here we go on to the next day. And what do you know, I woke up late, so here's me running as fast as I can to try and get 336, thankfully was 2 hours late today. And it wasn't until about 9:30 p.m. that my friend was finally able to come over, but it's alright, we still saw quite a few good things. Our first train tonight was train 335, same power that was on 336. 335, it's just basically the empty version of 336 after it runs around the loop over at the Rinker Lead in City Point, Florida.
1, 2, 3, My baby don't mess around because she loves me so.
Next up was train 208, then afterwards be 109, 109 being one of the other highlights of tonight, but 208 also having a pretty interesting freight consist. There we go. Now here comes 109, with a decent lash-up that we've been waiting for quite a while now. But I would also like to mention the horrible engine that's trailing on this train, 802. Trust me, when you hear this, you're gonna be like, oh my god, what in the world is going on with this engine? Now the reason I kept all of you guys for the entire length of that train is one, it was super short, second of all, it was extremely interesting for FEC saying most of their traffic is intermodal. Also, I'm pretty sure we can all agree, 802 does not sound healthy. That had been just about enough trains for us that night, we needed some sleep anyways for the big day. But first, 10 in the morning, here comes Southbound Manifest 103.
Thank you.
we're out here, world's longest radio thingy, and waiting on 920 and trespassing. So as you can see on this extremely grainy footage, is Weston's hand, and also our train.
Right after. 15,
and as it was a weekday, can't go without seeing the local. GP40-2, number 421 leading, Rock Train number 920. We were eating breakfast and we accidentally missed it going north, so here's it going south. And about 40 minutes later, we get our final train for quite a while, number 204, with a Jeep replacing one of the GEs. Have been nice if that Jeep ended up being the leader. It can happen, but it's pretty dang rare now that the GEs have been here.
Won't you help me sober up? All the big kids, they got drunk, and I wanna feel something again. Won't you help me feel something again?
How's it going again?
That's not beat. And now, the moment we've been waiting for. Almost. We were so excited to get a nice golden hour shot of the Brightline train, but what do you know? 206 has to come and get in the way, delaying the Brightline train. But it'll be alright in the end. At least we get to finally see the Brightline train. But first, here comes 206, mixed freight, rolling on through downtown Melbourne. Milepost 194. And about 45 minutes later, the final moment that we have been waiting for so long, after multiple delays in Jacksonville as well, we present the first new Brightline train set headed to West Palm Beach. Four more are to come, but we've been waiting for this moment for a long time.